So welcome everyone again. If you have not seen the first video, I am joined by Atul Anand. So we'll continue with the second video about the education system in Germany. And if you have not seen the first video about the admission requirements, then do check this video in the information card here. And I'll also put the description in the link below. So let's move on to the education system. What the first question which comes to everyone's mind when they hear the name Germany, I don't know if all of you know that. About the free education. So how far this is true and what are the things that one should know before talking about the free education in Germany?
This is like one of the most important factors when any student decides whether to study in Germany or not.
Yeah, true.
Yes.
Especially with non-Europeans, because you have higher tuition fees.
Yes, yes. And yeah, it is true. Like, but till some years back, like 2 years back, it was free all over Germany.
Okay.
But now, like 2 years back, a law was passed. Like in some states, the universities don't have free tuition fees. Okay.
Okay.
Like some states, and I am lucky, like RWTH is one of the universities in NRW state of Germany.
Okay.
And NRW has free tuition fees.
Okay.
Yes. And but depends, you have to check like whether it's there or not.
So can they find this information? Suppose they type a university name in DAD or some website, will they be able to see whether they charge tuition fees or not?
Yes, they can see.
Okay.
And they can check on the website as well. You guys can check on the website.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the place where you can check it, will leave the info link below in the description.
Yes, yes. And yeah, but don't
for you in RWTH Aachen, it is free.
Yeah, it's free.
Okay, okay.
But yeah, guys, don't forget the thing that you have to cover the cost of the expenses.
Yeah, the living expenses.
Yes, you are getting free tuition fee, but you are not getting scholarship. Okay, so scholarship means you are getting a stipend to study. That's not the case here.
Okay.
Like, yes, that you have to remember while deciding the expenses.
Okay. So we will discuss in details about the cost of living in the next video.
Yeah.
So do check the next video about life in Germany.
Yeah.
And moving on, what is the, like the, in general, like the coursework load and the assignments, projects, exams, how is the coursework decided and what is the teaching style like? It's a very general topic. You can just give some info in brief.
Yes, yes. Coursework, I would say like, it's not very much like India. Like, I am talking with respect to India.
Yeah, obviously, because you have bachelor's there.
Yes. So like in India, most of you guys are like used to studying just before the exams. Yes. But forget that here. If you start doing that, you are screwed. Yeah. So if you are here, like they go very detailed, like the course structure is very, very defined for every subject.
Okay.
Okay. But it's very lengthy. You have to study a lot, and here exams don't take place like in India. We don't have mid-sems, end-sems or what you say, internals or something like
okay,
that.
Okay.
We have just one exam at the end of the semester.
Okay, so in a year you have like two semesters and two exams.
Yes.
For each subject.
Yes, and each semester's length is like 6 months.
Okay.
So like it may be,
yeah, it's a bit different because in Netherlands we have this quarterly system. So
yeah,
we have like 15 ECTS each quarter.
Yeah.
So you have the same 60 ECTS in a year.
Yes.
But the only thing is that we have in each quarter, so the amount of load and the division of load is much different than what they have.
Yes.
And each have its own merits and demerits, so I don't want to go into deep into that.
Yes, yes. So basically we have a semester of 6 months.
Mm.
And you have to give all in that one semester, and the exams can be as long as 2 months.
Okay, so it reminds me of this, what you were saying before off camera, like the board exams that we have in India.
Yes.
Like that's very strange.
For 4 months, there will be classes. And then in the last 2 months, there will be exams. And you can choose your exam dates, but not like any random date.
Okay.
There are like for each exam, we have two dates in a semester.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You can choose which date you want to give the exam.
Yeah, I think we also have that. I think so. There is some choice, but I don't remember exactly what was there.
Yes. And there is another third date, but that third date is on the next semester.
Okay, so it's like a reset or something.
Yes,
like.
Yes. Like the subject is taught in even semester.
Okay.
It has two dates in the even semester and one date in the odd semester.
Okay.
Yeah.
So going into that, just for a small comparison, we have the quarterly system, but there are some courses which goes for only one quarter, and there are also some courses which goes for two quarters. So basically you can call it like a semester, but in real there is a quarter.
Yes. And yes, the attempts regarding that, like there is one more rule in RWTH you should know, that you have to pass one subject within three attempts.
Okay.
Yeah, like if you can't pass even one subject within three attempts,
okay,
then you are out of the university.
Oh my god, that's very terrifying.
Yes, like, yes. So like
I don't think we have that. Like if you have such situation in our case, you need to drop. You cannot obviously take that subject because it is already 2 years. You can choose other subjects, but you won't be deported for that. Here you will be deported if you don't cross 60 CTS in a year, but there are also some catch to that law, like there are some side conditions which doesn't always mean that you will be deported, but that is the basic criteria. Like
in this case, but something is different, like we don't necessarily have to complete 60 credits in 1 year.
Okay.
Like you can do your master's in 5 years.
Okay.
Doesn't matter how much time you take.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not prepared for the exam, just don't register for the exam, don't take that attempt.
Okay.
Your attempts will be counted, but
I think it is in the first year here, like maybe because they also know that here you are paying a lot of education fees.
Yes.
So maybe just to ease it for these non-Europeans,
yes,
they have
exactly
made this law.
Yes,
because in Germany the education is mostly
exactly
free. So
yes, exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, but yeah, one more thing, like when I said about free education,
mm-hmm,
not all the courses.
Okay.
In at RWTH there are some courses.
So RWTH is like the region or the
RWTH.
Okay.
In German it's called RWTH.
Okay.
So RWTH. I just say
RWTH. I know zero German and also zero Dutch. So
yes. So like there is an international academy, and a lot of you guys will be coming to the international academy. It is a bit different, like it is, they have tuition fees.
Okay.
Yes, like my course comes under state funding, so I have tuition fees.
So it's subsidized by the government.
Yes, but there are courses like PSC, KAME and some courses.
Okay.
Like
I think those things you can check in the website, we'll put it in the description below.
Yes, so you can see, you can check that. For that you have to pay tuition fees.
Okay.
Yes.
At least they know from this, that's good.
Yes.
And any short comment on the teaching style, if you...
Teaching style, yes. Like more in teaching you won't be having any complaint. Like the professors are really experienced, they know what they are talking about. And yes, but it...
Is there any situation, like based on my experience, many people also ask about that, like is there any situation or at some point do you feel like, okay, I expected that he should have taught it this, or he should have gone into that much depth,
yeah,
but he tries to keep it on the surface, or maybe he wants you to go into depth yourself or something. Do you have that kind of feeling anytime?
From I can say from my experience that, mm-hmm, not going into depth is not a complaint you are going to do in Germany.
Okay.
Yes, you definitely will be going to depth.
Okay.
Whatever you study, they will take you to the depths like you have never expected.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
That's for sure. But yeah, at some point of time, you may feel like you don't need to attend classes.
Hmm, okay. I mean, here also it is optional, but
yes.
Course, not mostly for exams, if the course have exams, then I would recommend attend classes, but in Germany it's different.
Yes. And yeah, you don't have attendance, compulsory attendance.
Yeah, that's also same, it's optional.
Yes. So you don't really have to attend classes, and you can like choose to just appear for the exam. And regarding exam preparation, like being very attentive in the class and doing everything, like impressing the professor and all, those things don't count.
Okay. So this is like a strict no-no for people who are coming from India, and
yes,
you know what we are talking
yes
about.
Doesn't matter if the professor knows your face or doesn't know your face, doesn't matter. Your marks will be only based on what you write in the exam. And for preparation, there is a fixed strategy you have to follow for exam preparation.
Okay.
You can't just like, I'm studying for knowledge and you think that you will score. No, maybe you will score bad because you have to prepare very strategically.
Yeah. Okay, so those kind of things are not going to work.
Yes.
That you indulge in some kind of shortcut and it's not going to work.
Yeah, it may be a bit like binding, but yeah, that's how it is in Germany. They are very strict.
Okay, yeah. And anything about the credit system, like I know I have talked a lot about the ECTS, like the European credit system.
Yeah.
So it is similar to the credits we have in courses in India, right? Like we have also credits, right?
Yes.
If I remember correctly. Like,
yes, yes.
So it is similar, like a course has a weightage of some hours and some amount of work you need to spend. Each ECTS, I forgot, it was somewhere around 20. You're supposed to work for 20 some hours for one ECTS. Was it like that? Like
I think so.
It was something like that. We'll put in the description below.
Yes, yes.
So it is something like a credit, a weightage for a course, which gives you an impression of the number of hours and time you need to spend in that course.
Yes, yes.
And what is the we have periods in India for different courses, because many people have a misconception that you have a timetable. But I mean, I heard from him that many people have contacted him and asked him like about the schedule of the courses or the timetable. So maybe you can say one.
Yeah, actually, if you guys ask like what's the timetable or something like that, it's not some period in school like you have some timetable. It's not like that. It varies. Like you have compulsory subjects, you have optional subjects. So if you are taking compulsory subject, some days I have classes at 8 o'clock to 9 or 10, then I have no classes throughout the day. And some days I have 8 to 1 or 1:30 fully packed.
So it boils down to two things, like the choice of your courses and the timing of those courses in that semester or something like
exactly.
that.
Yeah, the classes may be in the evening, it may be in the morning, it varies actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what about the frequency of the exams? I think it is per semester, right? We discussed before.
Yes.
And we also discussed about the type of the exams and preparation for the exams, mindset.
Yes.
Let's go to the final point. That is this has also many sub points like internship, thesis. We also have a thesis in the final year and the duration of the thesis, the structure and how you select a supervisor or a research group.
Yes.
And as you are also going to reach that point now because you are ending your first year.
Yes.
So although you have not experienced this, but you can shed some light on this.
Most of the courses have a compulsory internship program.
Okay. We also have that, like some, not every course, but actually I'm confusing now because here we call faculty and course. So faculty means like the departments we call in India, like computer science, electrical, electronics, and coursework means like the subjects. Because in India the terminology is different, so I just wanted to make it clear.
Yes.
And okay, you can continue. Like
We have like most of the courses have an compulsory internship.
Okay.
And it is like minimum 10 weeks in an industry. Okay.
So do you have certain number of ECTS for that?
Yes. Usually it's 15 credits.
Okay. So I guess it's the same because here also we have 15 ECTS mandatory or optional internship. It varies.
Yes, it varies. And you can choose to do your internship in an industry. And if you get a special permission from the faculty, like the board of exams board, then you can choose to do it in some research institute as well.
And if you want, can you do it for a longer period or you are bound to do it for 15 ECTS or 3 months?
You have to compulsory complete 10 weeks.
Okay.
But you can do it for a longer period.
Okay.
But only after 10 weeks, you can give your presentation in your university and you get your credits. But most of the companies here in Germany, they do not allow 10 weeks internship.
Yeah, that's true, because we also, I mean, sometimes they allow here, but I don't know the rules, like do they need to also apply for the work permit if you are doing internship, or it is not necessary if it is a mandatory internship?
Yes, work permit you already get. When you get residence permit,
okay,
you get the work permit along with that.
Oh, okay.
You don't have to apply differently for work permit.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Oh, I didn't know that. We don't have it here. I mean, you also have a student stay and you also have a work permit when you are a student in Germany.
Yes, yes.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes. So, you are...
Because here what happens is, I don't think a mandatory internship is needed, but if you do a part-time job, then your visa status is changed to work in Netherlands.
Okay.
So that goes through like a 2 or 3 week or 4 week process. So it requires some amount of work from your side also.
Okay.
But then in that sense, it is much better, much convenient.
Yes, like, it's convenient. So minimum the companies ask for a 6 months internship.
Okay.
Yeah. So only after 10 weeks, you can give your presentation and you can continue your internship in the company. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
And that's nice.
And regarding master thesis, it's about 30 credits usually.
That I think also will be varying from faculty, because here also we have like 60 very rarely, and sometimes it's 30, 45, it varies.
Okay.
We had 45, but my friend in mechanical in Netherlands had like 30, so I think it varies.
Yes. And master thesis also you can choose to do in an industry.
Industry, yeah, the same.
And if, the difference is if you do in industry, you get paid for
it.
Yeah.
I think most people, if I don't know exactly, but as per my experience, I think if you want to do a PhD, then maybe you should choose a university thesis. Otherwise, in all other cases, I think you should go for industrial thesis.
Yes, like, yeah. In university,
even in PhD also, you can do industrial thesis. It depends like what type of project and what type of work you choose.
Yes.
It's not like there's a hard and fast rule that you say A and B will come out. But
yes,
it's like...
Yes, exactly. It's up to your choice, like what you want to do. Like if you do a master thesis in company, it's good if you want to get a job in the industry later on. Yeah.
Okay.
And usually a lot of guys do like this. They get an internship in a company, and they do their master's thesis in the same company.
Okay.
Because you are already familiar with
that's
the
true,
people.
That's true.
Yeah, that's very convenient.
You are in a very advantageous position,
yes.
And then
yes.
Okay.
And then you can also get a job there.
Yeah, that's
if
true.
If luck favors, yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
So, I hope you understood some of these points. And you can always comment below, because I will put the links below how you can contact him, and we have a Facebook group. So instead of bothering him, you can also join the Facebook group and ask your questions.
Yes.
And maybe he will also redirect you to that Facebook group if he gets too many questions.
Yeah.
And so apart from this education system, once you arrive here, you need to have a good lifestyle, social life and other kind of things. So we will discuss that in the third video, next video. And again, if you have not seen the first video about the admission requirements before you start the education, then check the video in the information card that was pasted before. And we'll talk about the life in the next video.
So guys, as you can see, we have taken a lot of effort to make this video. I'm such a camera conscious person and I'm still sitting here sweating in front of you. So please smash the like button.
And don't forget to subscribe to get more such videos.
And please share this with your friends.
Do share.
Don't be selfish.